Thank you everybody for coming here. Especially I want to thank the presidency of Turks abroad and related communities for accepting of my paper to present here. After that I want to thank my moderator to chance give my presentations. Dear audience, before my giving my presentations, I would like to describe myself. My name is Saeyd Rashed Hasan Chowdury, Department of Mysticism, Ankara University in Turkey, and I am also Bangladeshi. I would like to share my research paper as the empowerment of women in Muslim communities, and I also have taken a case study of Republic of Turkey. Before starting my presentation, I would like to give the culture of Islam as Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and also Turkish culture Bunyad Ediyorum. Dear audience, my research on basis of three parts. I would like to highlight empowerment of women in a general perspective as well as other religion as Christian, Hinduism and Jews. After that, I would like to share empowerment of women in Islamic perspective as well as present Muslim countries. After that, I want to highlight empowerment of women in Turkey along with some recommendations. Ladies and gentlemen, you know that empowerment of women is a very classical concern issue in the present age of globalization. For this reason, I want to share that the concept of empowerment of women is in fact evolved or originated from Islamic laws, although there are many disputations and arguments on these issues. After that, I also share something, some recommendations, and my research tries to show that the concept of empowerment of women in Islam is wide and quite comprehensive and includes men and women are more equals in God's view and are prospective to fulfill the equivalent duties of adorations. After I want to share, you know, the empowerment of women, for this reason I want to take one historian, classical historian in the world, he also William Rowan Hamilton. He said that the rules, regulations and judgment regarding women in Islam are clear, absolutely clear and frank and open. The religion of Islam capitalizes on the whole attention that should be given to preservation of women against anything that may harm her personally or reason dispute to her nobility or reputations. They also said that on the perspective of Islam, but they have said a bit classical history about these matters. After that, I want to share some religion as well as on the effects or influence of religion about the empowerment of women. You know, the Christian religion is a very classical and also present classical religion in the world. The Christian, according to the Bible, wives are expected to be submissive in many ways. They are asked a lot only to be submissive to her husband, but church, their community, and God. At the time, we know that a lot of historian, a lot of Christian religion as well as said about these matters. After I have a couple of minutes for this reason, I want to share some titles because my topic generally in perspective of the world as a comparative women. After that, I want to share Hinduism. You know that Hinduism is known to be male-dominant religion, meaning women take a back seat, always said about these matters. After men have more duties within the community and to his family, where women are more of supportive element to the relationship. After I want to share some other religion as well as Buddhism. The Buddhism is well known in the Myanmar as well as South Asian perspective. You know, the according to the Buddhist, he said that the experience of women across different from Buddhism. And Buddha told the wives should be obedient to their husband. He also taught that husbands should respect their wives. After, I want to share in my perspective as well as Muslim community in the world. You know that Islam is a complete code of life. For this reason, Islam said a lot of matters about this, again, about this empowerment of women sector. And you know that empowerment of women is a very classical issue. For this reason, there are a lot of verse in the Holy Quran, as well as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, he said that a classical history, classical recommendation about this Muslim woman's life. After I want to share some quote here. The women have got from the Islam, including her education, employment opportunities, rights to inheritance, after the dress, age of marriage, freedom to consent of marriage, marriage contract, after they have got the mohar from the husband, after permissibility of birth control and divorce, sex outside or before marriage, they also forbidden from in the Islamic religion, after her ability to receive justice in case of sex crimes, you know about these matters, after property rights, independent of her husband. But I want to quote some verses and also quote from the Holy Quran. Holy Quran, you know that there is a lot of verses in the Holy Quran as well as Surah An-Nisa. Only one surah is said that only for women. For this reason, I want to quote here the Queen of Sheba's acceptance of Prophet Sulaiman, invitation to Islam, was also mentioned in details with the chapter of Surah An-Naml. After that, you know that the Pharaoh is a very one kind of this against leader in the Islam as well as the Musa alayhi salam. At the time, Allah Rabbul Alamin says that mentioned in this wives of the Pharaoh, Allah said that as an example for the faithful person, the Pharaoh's wife, who accepted all times of suffering for the sake of Allah. After that, you know that the Christian religion as well as history of Mary about a lot of matters in the present world and a lot of disputations and argument issues in the present world. But Quran said that Quran described in the detail with the story of Mary and her extraordinary birth of Jesus Christ and how she answered to her peoples, the Jews, as like Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, we know that allegations of being unpractical. After you know that Mary, that means Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam, was accorded great dignity in the Holy Quran. After I want to share two quotes from the Hadith, peace be upon him, Rasulullah said that whoever bring affront to daughters, he and I will arrive alongside in the day of judgment. After another Hadith, Abu Hurairah said, narrated from the Rasulullah said that let him be a lamb tag three times. He also said that someone asked, who is he? The Rasulullah said that the one who has lived to see his parents or one of them and did not enter paradise. It's a very classical quote from the Hadith. After you know that, I have a couple of minutes for this reason. I want to share as Muslim countries and general perspective. You know that Abdurrahman and Nasibat is two feminists in the United States of America, but they also feminists, but they told about this very classical quote from the empowerment of women in Islamic perspective. They told that Muslim woman is the first woman in the world to be recognized for her legal rights and economical rights, and they also included that the family system in Islam was legislated 1400 years ago in order to hold cornerstone of the family and the society. After the classical said that about this matter to say feminists in the United States, after that, you know, I want to share, I have taken as a case study of my empowerment of Turkey. For this reason, I want to highlight some quote from the Turkey perspective. You know that there are three categories in Turkey, as well as I want to share the historical context of women rights in Turkey, three different phases here. For first phase is 1839, including the widespread spectrum of rules and regulation in the Tanzimat period. In Tanzimat period, the Ottoman Empire, when the Ottoman Empire has completed their rules and regulations, at the time they also started to give the classical rights to the women at the time. At the time, you know, the Ottoman Empire started reform policy of laches, which also influenced women in every sector in the Turkey. After, you know, that 1923, at the time when the Republic of Turkey has started and newly from the Ottoman Empire, at the time, the Mustafa Kemal Atatürk, the president of this Turkey, he told that a comparative portion of the modernization model, a method in the Pacific of Turkey, at the time he have given to the women as a full voting rights in 1934. After another different pages has been changed in 1980, at the time you know that the intervention by the arms in this Turkey, at the time the some second wave feminism has been started. At the time there also a lot of protest to get the full rights from the government. At the time second wave feminism has been started. At the time the Turkey policy and like its own sector has been reformed and also changed. After I want to share the United Nations system to the Turkish policy, you know that recognize the United system, equality is an essential consideration of in human rights and development. The United System in Turkey has identified women and children rights as one of the top three areas of focuses for 2006 or 2010. At the time, Turkey has sensible about this matter. After, you know that in June 2000, the European Commission, as like European Union, has influenced very different method to the Turkish women sector. At the time, you know, towards community framework strategy in gender equality, as well as they said that gender equality, but they also influenced in this women sector, which proposes to start and outline European Union activities for reaching the objective of eradicating inequality between men and also women. After you know that, I also shared one graph. You know that 2015 and 2016 and women participation in the labor market in the Turkey, as well as 2015 12.9% and also 2016 15% has involved in Turkish labor sector. After I also share some quote from the present government here. Present government has taken some influence and also some take the decision on the empowerment of women in Turkish sector. You know that women empowerment rate in the present situation is 25% into 6% and unemployment rate is 11%. After the general ratio in higher education is 83%. After you know that in 45% of them in 2011 election. After I want to share in initiative such as Heidi, Kizla Rakula, the boosting system and regional boarding secondary for primary education and cross transferring education in Turkish the present situation. After I want to share in 2013 election, at the time you know that 2,948 mayors were elected. At the time 27 of women were elected as a province as like as Bashkan, as like as. After that you know I want to share some figures. After you know that, I want to share some quotes. The Turkish present government have eradicated this woman. They also previous times they had a lot of problems here to wear the hijab. At the time, the Turkish government withdrew the hijab in the university and also police level and also army at the time. Civil service in 2013 for job codes in 2015 and women in military 2017. After that, women in the Turks armed forces have been given the full rights to wearing hijab in move that performed a significant cultural shift within institutions seen historically as a caretaker Turkish civil identity. After I have 2 minutes for this season, I want to say that some challenges in the present world as like as Muslim countries. You know that the age of globalization for this season, some country as like as European country and African country has wanted a freedom rights. After you know that the Asian countries as like as African countries, the some women has been oppressed by the men. This is the problem here. After second point, free from boundaries. After third point, you know that current function of prison, life dowry, prostitution, kidnapping, rape, acid throwing. After the suicide and sexual harassment in the present situation. After problem of Muslim countries policy, some problem do not follow the Quran and Sunnah in Muslim countries. This is the problem in the present situation. After some women demand want to free society. After you know that misconception about the Islam religion as well as the empowerment of women. Muslim women are slaves to their husband. This is the problem. After the women or also European countries and also America demanded the Islamic perspective, women are backward. After they also oppressed in the religion of Islam. After they told that women are completely devoid spiritual, social, economic, and political rights. This is the problem here. After I want to some recommendation here, you know that the role of OIC, Organization of Islamic Cooperation, in empowerment of women sector should be determined to among the Muslim countries on basis of Islam. After I am to share second, a common delegation on Islam and the Muslim countries in the world. For this reason, some president, also Muslim leader, as well as very strong against the allegation of this sector, as well as empowerment of women sector. After I want to share that Muslim countries should take the national policy to protection the rights of women, not be subjected to oppression of any matters or by any people. After the Muslim countries organizing public awareness, and also boys and girls to take the proper education. For this reason, I want to complete of my presentation. Thank you everybody for hearing of my presentation. Thank you.